Glimpses of India. Introduction. This chapter is divided into three parts. In each part, we come to know about the lesser known facts and glimpses of a country's famous destinations, Goa, Coorg, and Assam. Part 1. A Baker from Goa. About the author. Lucio Rodriguez was one of the few outstanding Konkani essayists. He was also a professor of English and often wrote periodicals for newspapers. Goa is one of the states of India where Portuguese influence could be still seen in its art, culture, custom, cuisine, and in architecture. In this part of narrative, author writes a pen portrait of traditional baker who has an important place in the Goan society. Narrator tells that elderly people of Goa fondly remember about good old Portuguese days and their love for famous loaves of bread. The traditional family business of baking is still carried on by younger generation. In Goan village, baker is also known as peder and can be seen twice a day selling door-to-door bakery products. The narrator recalls that during his childhood days, early in the morning, the thud and the jingle of the traditional bamboo stick of baker would wake them up. Then they ran outside to meet him and chose the sweet bread bangles carefully from the basket of the baker. The jhang jhang sound made by the bamboo staff was a signal of arrival of baker. Listening that musical sound, the lady of the house and children came out to purchase the bakery products. After greeting good morning to the lady, when the baker kept his basket on the vertical bamboo stick, children used to gather around his basket inquisitively. The children were mildly rebuked and asked to stay away from the basket when the baker delivered the bakery products to the maid servant of the house. But they wouldn't stop peeping into the basket out of curiosity and love for the sweet flavored bread bangles. The narrator further says that he hasn't forgotten the sweet fragrance of the bread loaves and bangles. Being a kid, they never bothered to brush their teeth or wash their mouth to relish their favorite bread bangles because for them, a cup of hot tea could do this job of cleansing much better. The traditional bread is still an integral part of the ceremonies in Goa, whether it is marriage or Christmas celebrations. Sweet bread bowl is the requisite part of every marriage gift. It is essential for the mother to prepare sandwiches on the occasion of her daughter's engagement. Cakes and bolinas are must during the Christmas as well as in other festivals of Goa. Thus, no one can ignore the importance of baker and his bakery products in Goan society. The narrator tells that Portuguese baker wore a peculiar dress called cabai, which was single piece of long frock to knee length. But during his childhood, he saw baker wearing a shirt and trousers which reached just below the knees. Nowadays, if someone is seen wearing such knee-length trousers, he invites the comment that he is dressed like a peder. The author further says that the baker came to collect the bills at the end of the month only. According to the narrator, in good old days, baking was a profitable business. The Goan bakers were considered as happy and prosperous people. Their plump physique was a symbol of prosperity. Even today, any person having such physical appearance is compared to baker. Things to know: Goa was a colonial state of the Portuguese Empire. Pen portrait means informal description of a person or a group of people.